is we're gonna add water to the base of this glacier to see if it moves any faster, which this one is moving pretty quick as it is. Daniel, could you please hold down the... Yeah, there you go. So we're gonna put this in the back, just like that. And this straw is full of water. We're gonna put this in the back. Let it go. And now this water should be in the base of this glacier. So now we're gonna let it...
Oh, it's way faster.
Is that faster to you guys?
Yes.
It looks faster to me too.
Oh my god.
Oh wow, look at that. So this is where it should get a little messy. But it should also be very entertaining. Students typically love this type of thing. They really enjoy making the glacier material. And this model really shows very well how glaciers move down a U-shaped ravine in mountainous regions. So do you guys think that glaciers move fast or slow now?
I mean, at first it seems like, at first I thought they moved like really slow, like a, sort of like a snail, but way slower, like the snail equivalent of rocks, sort of. But now we see it's not that slow. I mean, it's still somewhat slow, but considering to what I was thinking, like an inch a month, way faster.
Okay, what do you think, Brio? Fast or slow?
About medium or something like that.
Okay, let me ask you this. Does it move faster or slower if it's hotter outside?
Faster.
And why is that?
Because if it melts, it makes more water, and the water makes it go faster.
That's right. So we have what force keeping it from flowing? What was the word you almost said?
I forgot what it's called. Something.
Friction
is right. So as the water flows on the base of this glacier, it's reducing the friction and thereby letting it flow faster. So the more melting we get, the faster our glacier will flow.
Okay.
You guys have any questions?
No, nothing.
I'll tell you what, hold on 1 second with your question. We're gonna come back and take a look at our finished product and answer any questions.